Hey, je m'appelle Joe Anderson. Je suis le chef de théâtre ici. And it gives me a great deal of pleasure to welcome you all here to Bluff City Theatre for the second of our plays in the 2017 series, C'est la vie. We have a big group tonight, including a whole bunch of people from the French Club. Where are our French Club members here? It gives me a great deal of pleasure to introduce this production. You know, normally here at Bluff City Theatre, we try to do plays that are a little more serious. People say that they've never heard of them. You've probably never heard of this one either, but it's a wonderful little musical by Gregg, Opelka, a playwright of Chicago. He was actually down here last Friday for opening night. It was really great to have him come see this. When we were talking, he told us that he grew up loving the music of Edith Piaf, and he wanted to do a musical about Edith Piaf, but he didn't want to do an Edith Piaf retrospective because those have been done to death. So he actually created this, which is an entirely original. The entire score is original, but as you go through it, you'll recognize that so much of it is very reminiscent of the music of Edith Piaf in that particular era. So, just a wonderful little musical. It's 90 minutes, no intermission, and I think you're really going to enjoy it. I would like to pay respect to our sponsor for this evening, which is Golden Eagle Distributing. Now, this is the first year that Golden Eagle has signed on as a sponsor, so I'm really pleased to see that so many of you are imbibing copiously of their rent. maybe we'll get them back again next year, I certainly hope so. Anyway, thank you very much. Enjoy the show, and without further ado, set up.
Madame, Monsieur, j'ai le très grand plaisir de vous souhaiter la bienvenue chez le Gregg. Oh, pardon, ladies and gentlemen, it is me a large pleasure to wish all of you this beautiful evening a very warm welcome to Chez Le Gregg, our little nightclub set right in the heart of the off Monopolis. Tonight, your two favorite songbirds, Dominique and Fatigue, have a wonderful surprise in store for you. But before we start, Chez Le Gregg, a few brief words. Premièrement, there will be no cocktail served until after the show is over. This is because tonight our waiter, Eve, is also operating the light bulb for the first time. And yes, as you can see, it is all about Eve. At this moment, no photographs, please. If you want to see pictures of our two lovely stars, I suggest you go to the police station. Now, mes amis, chez Le Play is on to present the girls with the low notes and the high heels. The girls who give the oomph, the arc de triomphe. The girls who put the heures and chanteuses. Dominique Jolie and Fatiguée pour Boo. In our one night only presentation of their new musical sorbet, C'est la vie.
No. I want to sing. Sometimes they come on their own, and other times you must call for them.
And it is the case, they're not worth the whistle.
Gay, don't be so pessimistic. After all, tonight, we have gained our liberty. We are free, free as birds to sing whatever we like. No, monsieur, the play breathing down our neck.
Oh, pardon. You do not understand this part. You see, dear audience, Monsieur Laplay, our boss, is the owner of this cabaret. I know. It is lovely, isn't it? And Henry Laplay is. How shall I put it?
He is demanding.
She means he's a bastard. He makes us sing only the songs of Edith Piaf. Every night. Night after night after night.
Thank you.
speaking of L'Amour.
That never stopped me from crying before. Come on, turn us on, I'll have you see.
Don't get out of it.
Oh, come on, Fatty Gary, how is that hot man of yours?
Gaston, well, you are only half right. He is hot, but he is not a man. He's a rat. He's a skunk. And I dumped him like an ashtray as soon as I found out about Jeanette. Bringing me Swiss chocolates and American cigarettes. And all the time, too timing me with that cheap customs agent.
No!
What do you think he got the chocolates and the cigarettes?
Men.
But he was so beautiful. His voice was like a symphony. His body like a rhapsody. His mom.
A non-entity.
Do you think I cared about his mind when he was kissing me?
Nevertheless, you are better off without him. Oh, besides, there are a million other men in Paris.
I suppose you mean that as comfort. But there are a million more pigs out there like him. No, don't make sense. I am through with L'Amour. It is tiresome. And worse, it is repetitive. It's like those stupid old songs they used to sing before the first war with them. Blue skies and full moons and red roses and all that other mad. Most people count birthdays to tell how old they are. I count family affairs and divide by two. Last year it was Marcel and Andre. The year before that it was Pierre and Philippe. Mm. And the year before that it was Mikhail and Antoine.
Really? Three is that year?
It was a leap year. I had an extra day.
Ah, me. Of course. Oh, but pretty fatty gay. You know as well as I do. 6 weeks, a month from now, some handsome garçon will come strolling into chez le play. He'll buy you a cocktail. More likely, you'll buy him a cocktail. But then you go again, singing those same old songs. Blue skies, full moons, red roses.
Mary, not moi. I've learned men don't need car like taxis. When you don't need ones, they're everywhere. And when you do, you're better off walking. But you know what the worst part about this is? I miss the American cigarettes.
Oh!
I told them I could try. change my costume.
Ah, her grandchildren is coming up. She wants to make a big impression. What shall I do? I could pay our guests while you are gone.
Tell them a little bit about your love life, Dominique. That'll give me enough time to try on every outfit in the dressing room. Twice.
Oh, pay no attention to Fatty Gay. She is just jealous of my natural good looks. It's true, though. I never met a mirror I didn't like. But she will take it out on me in little ways. Just watch. When she comes back onto stage, instead of choosing one of her own half dozen boas, what will she be wearing? My favorite rose feather boa. Whee! She does it all the time. But if I say something to her about it, she'll say, oh, is this yours? It was just as it was all the other ones. I just grabbed the first one I saw. It won't happen again. Till the next time. And the next. And that. I just watch. Oh, it's not that I mind sharing, comprenez-vous? It's just that, this boa, the rose peasant boa, it was a gift from a very special monsieur. You see, Fatigue, she thinks that because I have beauty, I have many gentlemen friends. And in a way, she's right. I do have many gentlemen friends. So they buy me gifts, they take me to little restaurants, they tell me all their little triumphs and all their little tragedies, and we have a great little time. But, I do not have any gentlemen lovers. Pourquoi? They are afraid. Bizarre, n'est-ce pas? Who would have thought it? Such big men afraid of such a little woman.
She is a wonderful entertainer. After all, I trained her myself. when there are so many to choose from in the dressing room. I just grabbed the first one I saw.
But you always grab my rolls, Pezzabola.
Tony, I think he needs a little break. You look like Hamlet after his visit with his dead papa. Jiggy, take that poor little sparrow into the dressing room and pour her a nice big glass of brandy. She's a little bit nervous about our maiden voyage. Just right. And I'll take care of her. That's right. A little shot is just plain. I'll be here too.
Some mood that you use.
footsteps go by on the stairs. I've been shot, I hope you said your prayers. And we fix up the box like rivalries. And we both give our weapons a squeeze. He went la 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 la. So I killed him. He went la la la. And the judge asked me, how do you plead? I cried, wait, I committed this deed. I am guilty, but I'm not insane. If it pleases the court, I'll explain. He went la 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 la, so I killed him. He went la 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 la, for your honor, I still care. And to my great surprise, the judge looked in my eyes and said, stop!
Desist.
He said, rise and go, kids. This is clear self-defense. Case dismissed! I cried, la 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 la. Now my troubles are little. I cried, la 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 la. I'm so high, I drew my first acquittal. And it all goes to show.
History.
Dominique Joliet is back in Paris, and in finer pheasants than ever, and the valet Russe is vodka under the bridge.
Vodka, Volta. Who cares? What difference does it make what you drink? It's all the same.
Oh, poor Fatigue is still pining over that pig, Gaston. I can see his captain.
Once again, Dominique, you are only half right. It is Gaston, but I do not pine. Country milkmaids pine. Pale secretaries pine. Stage girls like me, free rat and rail. What is it about you men? Who are you so worthless? Why do you have no conscience?
Don't forget shame.
Why are you such cowards?
Oh, don't mince your words, Fatigue.
You are such spineless creatures. All you ever do to us is lie to us and leave us. And then when you do leave us, you don't have the decency to say you are leaving. You just pop out of the picture. As if we never existed. No. If I never see another man in all my life, that'll be just fine with me. What do you want? We'll see. Go write a symphony or something.
Oh, pretty egg. Calm down now. JPP, he's different.
Different? Next you'll be telling me that the Eiffel Tower is tall.
Come on, I need a drink. See?
How did you know that?
we're so, so lucky to have him. Who cares if he gets up at 2 in the afternoon?
When he gets up?
So he's always hung over at the rehearsal.
When he comes to them?
Oh, then he has little money.
Except in racing season when he has none.
Nevertheless, we are very, very lucky to have him.
We terribly love him. Notice we are still performing here. You've been working on those same 8 measures for weeks. Oh, either finish it or drop it. I keep sanding it up.
We smoke as much as she does.
We drink as much as she does.
We
sing as well as she does.
money and men. I can't think of a single thing.
She has it.
It.
Really? It, it.
What exactly is it? It.
She has, what do they say in America? Leukemia. You remember the headlines for her first nightclub job? From gutter to glitter. Street legend type singer. Little orphan needy finds her home. I tell you, that girl is a genius. She perfected the fine art of looking impoverished to get work.
What am I talking about?
The waist look. The outstretched arms, it says, hitting me. The vacant stare, it says, help me. The quavering vibrato that says, believe me. Tell you, it was as real as a gypsy's hope.
Oh, so why did we spend all those years training and suffering?
Because we were foolish. We didn't know any better. We were young and beautiful. And now we're just beautiful. Which is all right. We are not yet too old to learn.
To learn what?
The fine art of looking impoverished to get what? Many girls want to be a cabaret star and dress up in velvet and lace. They think if you're talented, you will go far, but believe me, that isn't the case.
They speak in hushed tones of men like George Benching, with the finest old masters they train. No drinks, no narcotics, and no nicotine. I know. But alas, all that work is in vain.
For it doesn't taste to bring its essence of ruling, and for God's sake, forget your fuzzy word. The road to success starts and ends with your dream. Cleopatra. You just hooked another marquette for me.
How do you know that they're not for you?
Look carefully, no thorns.
He sets them down. You know when Francois and I split them, he sent me as a farewell gift a Venus flytrap. Said I could give it a few pointers.
How right he was.
Oh, look, there's a little card. Addressed to Fatigue for good. They are for you. It's a miracle.
It is not that miraculous. Madame Fogel, bon chance to make your new show from your secret admirer. A secret admirer?
Oh, Fatigue, that is fantastic.
No, it is not. It is awful. Who needs a secret admirer? I want a public admirer. What good is one other cowardly man afraid to show his face?
But at least he's not afraid to show his feelings, huh? Don't you get gift bouquet in the mouth, huh? You don't want the latte, though.
Don't touch my beautiful flowers.
Oh, flowers! A moment ago they were weeds.
That's when I thought they were yours. I wonder who sent them.
I don't know. Better not be that man in the tuxedo I danced with in my song. He is for moi.
What? You mean that old gentleman? That little cute one?
Wait.
Oh, no, you don't. I saw him winking at me to unwise say au revoir.
Winking? Oh, he wasn't winking. He was blinking. He spilled some drink in his eye. I saw the whole thing.
Excuse me, moi. I think I know a wink from a blink. I've been around the block a few times.
Oh, don't be so humble. That black knows your feet by heart. No, my dear. An involuntary facial spasm is not an invitation for a tête-à-tête.
It was a wink.
Oh, Fatigue, can you believe this? We are doing our own show. Isn't this exciting?
Incredible was the word I had in mind.
You know what I think? I think that tomorrow night we do it for the play.
Oui. And then the night after that, we open at the Maylon Rouge with a 30-piece orchestra.
You know what is wrong with you? You have forgotten how to dream. Don't you want to escape this place?
Monsieur Dominique, you are priceless. Escape is what they made the cinema for. It's the only place we can get away from this cemetery and Monsieur Leclerc.
And Monsieur Gaston?
Who needs Gaston? I have a secret admirer. And what about you, Pompetite? You haven't told me anything about your love life lately. Perhaps Mademoiselle has a new lover?
Oh, Fatigue. With me, lovers are like croissants. I can get a new one every morning, but by the afternoon, they are stale. Why can't real-life men be like some men in the cinema? Do you remember that film we saw at Le Bijou two Saturdays ago?
Last summer? That was a beautiful film. Do they make any men more handsome than Pierre Legendre? Pale visage, pale figure. They're playing it again tomorrow night. Let's go see it one more time, huh?
No, I don't want to see it again.
Pourquoi? I'll give you some money. You love that film even more than I did.
I do love it. That is why I don't want to see it again. It reminds me too much of what men aren't like. Do you remember in the final scene when she is walking alone to the garden? And you think he's going to leave her?
And the music, how did it go?
Then, at the final moment, instead of getting on the train, he turns around.
It was a sad melody.
He gently takes her by the hand.
They promise.
Rain across the sand. Summer rain begins to fall.
Make a windy night or a rainy morrow, the very next day, the National Theater at Apple was open.
just like that. Suddenly I had nothing. No job, no money, no maitre d', just a wine-stained little notebook full of ideas I copied from this game. Fortunately, Monsieur LePlay had just opened up this charming lot and agreed to take a chance on
a cast-off?
I wasn't too excited about the idea, but it did keep the wolf away from the door for a few weeks, and then for a few years, until keeping the wolf away became a way of life. Ernest.
Come on.
That was his name.
Is it maitre d'?
No, the wolf.
Watch it all, watch it.
all of you back. But since that is not very probable, I just want to say tonight how much Fatigay and I appreciate your indulgence. Fatigay, she feels the same way I do. She will just never admit it. It's not her style. Speaking of Fatigay, she'll be back any moment to sing her final song, and then we have one final song for you before we send you on your way. And for our finale, we require a special bottle, not mere Bordeaux, champagne! So, I hope you like your dry, monsieur. Don't go away, I'll be right back.
Mesdames, just for a little moment. Je vous prie. I am changing the program. I am going to sing this number instead. Is it all right? Trivia. This song is for the boy who gave me the idea. And as they say in America, hit it!
Where are all the boys that I used to know? When they're just right here, did you see them go? I don't want them back, but I am wondering so. Where are the boys? How did they come by? Did we laugh at chess? Did we drink till dawn? Did we have a rest? Where have those days gone? We were not impressed, but we did.
Not long ago, we were just barely sober.
about our little tavern and what transpires there.
And with whom?
Fatigue. I think I had too much to drink at night. How does it start?
There's a small tavern in town.
The ones that say nearly shut down.
The musicians who play there all pay for no pay there, and everyone acts like a clown. And they play games of chance, they drink there and dance there, till everyone gets out of hand. And you know you're all right at the end of the night if you're one of the few who can stand.
Our emotions?
Monsieur Big Producer. Mr. King of the nightlife. Mr. King of the copycats, that's who you are. Well, I want you to know one thing. Tonight, Dominique and I sing our own repertoire. All original material. And your audience loved us.
See, in France, we have a little saying. Say.